Okay, what we're going to go over tonight is different ways on to get the person off balance, get them in an awkward position to where you can actually hit them again. A lot of the stuff that we do in the dojo puts the person in an awkward position or an advantageous position for you to where you can go for another attack if need be, or to go ahead and take the guy out. So if he's here squared up with me, as long as we're still here even, side to side, he can push me side to side, we're still even. Pushing going to the back, same way, okay? Couple different ways that you can get a person off balance is, again, if I push him back, I can push him off balance, same way for me, okay, here. Or I could actually pull him off balance. Same thing, go with the hands as well. We're actually gonna work with a couple different ideas that you can play with in your dojo. Stuff that we teach in ours here at CMAI. So we're actually talking about if he comes in to push, I'm going back from here. What I want to do is to actually maneuver and turn my body. So if he comes in, that his momentum's coming forward, I'm actually going to just cut and turn to continue his momentum forward and pass. So as he comes through, I'm going to maneuver here. Now my hand's going to chamber up. Now I could actually strike out, hit to here. His hands come up again as I maneuver. If that one drops, now I have this here. Now I can actually strike in this direction. I can bring the hands back up, hook up underneath. So whenever you're working on your grappling with your hands coming through, if the hands come in and touch, if I bring across here, I can come the opposite direction as well. Take the slack out of the wrist joint. I'm gonna take my hand to here. I'm not trying to peel the hand off. If his hand stuck to me, I know where it's at. He's got two hands engaged on one. Now I can actually strike and hit from here. In this instance, if I want to grapple, I'm going to go again along the cuff or the band of the wrist, taking the slack out. I actually want to catch right into the crook of the wrist joint, right into here. As I do this, just that little movement gets him going this direction. If we go the opposite way, you can see from here, as I maneuver, I take the slack out of the wrist. I'm going to place my hand on top to continue on, and now I can get him to go. Notice I moved very little, he moved a lot. Okay, so we'll try it off at an angle. So when he comes through to here, as I catch, trap the hand, I can strike coming up, catching along the band of the hand here, along to the inside. Now I can catch in, strike. Notice the arm locked, I can pop to here, catch through. So there's a couple different things you come through. So from here, maneuver the hands. This one slipped. I can catch to here. Now, opens up long five, allow me access to tap the jawline. One more time. So we do the combination, boom, to here. I actually strike to the head. Lay the hand, cut across. Notice lung five is here. It opens up, so I'm going to come down. I'm going to pop to the inside of lung five. Now it allows me access to the jawline, the whole band of the jaw, stomach four, five, and six, triple warmer 17, large intestine 18. Stretch up into here. I can strike into the head. If I want to grapple the head, I can release and go again. Okay? So it's a couple of different things you can actually work with in your dojo. So if he's coming forward this direction, maneuver, step off, catch in. I can even use my hands. I don't even have to use my forearms. I can grapple to here. Same thing. Actually strike. Now, notice as I catch through, I cut. Brings the head into here. Now I can access and grapple the head as well. So there's a couple different things that you can work on from the arm grappling and movements as we teach at CMAI. If you like what you see, hit the subscribe, tell your friends about it, and send me a message in the comments below. I'd love to hear what you think. If you have an idea on the technique that you want us to see us break down, by all means, shoot us a message, and we'll see you soon.